To Gretna.
Thank you
very much. For a very, very special occasion, the renewal of your wedding vows and a blessing on 20 years of marriage. It's wonderful. So we're going to be saying thank you, God, for 20 years of marriage. Thank you, God, for the love we have for each other. Thank you, God, for our family and our friends and all the good gifts that we have to enjoy. And I was really quite touched by your when you gave me a little biog of yourself and said you've done. I've given a lot to your family, which parents, grandparents do. Now it's time to enjoy each other's company more, and that's important. Yeah, and do all the things that you've always wanted to do. Yes, and children have grown up and made their own way. The 18-year-old is the youngest, is that right?
Yes.
He or she?
That's a he.
He's
yeah, still at home.
But he'll be making his own way in the world, shortly. It's time to just enjoy. Yes. But we're going to celebrate all of that. You couldn't have chosen a better room than this one, because matter of fact, this is the original marriage room where it all began. So in those days, the runaway brides, as they were called, would come through that door, and that is the original door, into this room, not the original anvil, that's in the museum. But this one is still pretty old, it goes back to 1942. So you'll be blessed over the anvil and renew your vows over the anvil. So you're getting very much the Gretna tradition, and of course, very importantly, receiving God's blessing on this special day for you both. So we have come together in the presence of God to celebrate with Tracy and Steve and to ask for God's blessing upon their marriage. Tracy and Steve, you stand in the presence of God as man and wife to dedicate to him your life together, that he may consecrate your marriage and empower you to keep the covenant of promise you have solemnly declared. The scriptures teach us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of his grace, a holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that as husband and wife give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives, they shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy, in sickness and in health. It is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. This is the meaning the marriage that you have made. And you now wish to affirm your desire to live as followers of Christ, and you have come to him, the fountain of grace, that strengthened by the prayers of the church, you may be enabled to fulfill your marriage vows in love and faithfulness. Let us keep silence and remember God's presence with us now. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Say the prayer together if you're able to read it. Okay, don't worry. You're okay. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God our Father, you have taught us through your Son that love is the fulfilling of the law. Grant to your servants that loving one another they may continue in your love until their lives end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Steve and Tracy, you have committed yourselves to each other in marriage, and your marriage is recognised by law. The Church of Christ understands marriage to be, in the will of God, the union of a man and a woman, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till parted by death. Is this your understanding of the covenant and promise that you have made?
It is.
Now, I'm going to relieve you of those now because I will just keep you running now all the way through.
Fantastic.
You can now turn into face each other and I will keep you right as we go through. Steve, I'm going to say some words to you, and then when I nod my head, if you could reply, that is my resolve with the help of God. Okay. Steve, have you resolved to be faithful to your wife, forsaking all others, so long as you both shall live?
That is my resolve by the help of God.
And likewise, if you could reply, that is my resolve with the help of God. And then with my head. Okay? Tracy, have you resolved to be faithful to your husband, forsaking all others, so long as you both shall live?
That is my resolve with the help of God.
Okay. Are you wanting to say any personal vows at this time? No, you're okay.
No, that's fine.
I always give everybody the opportunity because sometimes they say, oh no, we're not, and then they change their mind on the day. So I just set that moment, but not everybody does go for that, by the way. So, well, what I'm now going to do is bless the rings. These rings that you'll wear for the rest of your lives are symbols of the love you have for one another, and very much reminding you of the vow and covenant you made on your wedding day, and of course reminding of your blessing today. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Steve and Tracy a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, and of the promise that they have made to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. If you could take Tracy's ring, please, and place it on her left hand forefinger. And just hold it there and repeat after me, please. Tracy, I give you this ring.
Tracy, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Never fit on the deal, by the way. You could take Steve's ring.
Yeah, his will only fit on his little finger.
Whatever finger yes, that's fine. Okay. And just you hold it there. Repeat after me, please, Tracy. Steve, I give you this ring.
Steve, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
With my body, I honour you.
And all that I am, I give to you.
And all that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Almighty God, give you grace to persevere, that he may complete in you the work he has already begun. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you send your Holy Spirit to be the life and light of all your people. Open the hearts of these your children to the riches of his grace, that they may bring forth the fruit of the Spirit in love and joy and peace. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Eternal God, true and loving Father, in holy marriage, you make your servants one. May their life together witness to your love in this troubled world. May unity overcome division, forgiveness heal injury, and joy triumph over sorrow. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Love is patient and kind. It is not jealous or conceited or proud. Love is not ill-mannered or selfish or irritable. Love does not keep a record of wrongs. Love is not happy with evil, but is happy with the truth. Love never gives up, and its faith, hope, and patience never fail. We ask for God's blessing on this couple's home, to make it a home of love, peace, and joy. We ask for God's blessing on their children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and all family and friends. And God will bless them all as a family, and watch over them on their journey of life. And we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord turn his face to you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look down upon you and give you peace. And every blessing to you both, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. You've now received God's blessing, and I know you haven't been married here because you've done that, but I'm going to just end with the traditional Gretna fling.
He's
going to
kill us.
Where I'm going to strike the anvil and say, I have now blessed this couple and declared them very, very securely as man and wife.
You know I'd gladly go anywhere you take me. It's so amazing to be loved. I'd follow you to the moon and the sky above. Tell you how you thrill me. I'm happy as I can be. You have come and it's changed my whole world. What a wonderful day. It's so amazing to be loved. I'd follow you to the moon and the sky above. Ooh, 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 I'd go. And it's so amazing, amazing. I could stay forever. Forever, here in love and leave you never. Cause we've got amazing love. Truly it's amazing, so amazing. Love brought us together, together. I would leave you never and never. Yes, we've got amazing love. Ooh, so amazing. And I've been waiting for a love like you. It's so amazing to be loved. to the moon and the sky above. Oh, and it's all, it's all, it's so amazing to be loved. I follow you to the moon and the sky above. And you and I, it's all, to the moon and the sky.